In some animals, skin spines are developed into pedicel area. Some echinoderms spines are modified into pedicel area. These are useful for defense. They give protection to body, and sometimes they also cleanness of the body. These are the beak like structures are known as the pedicel area. They useful for defense and also cleanness of the body. Circulatory system. In circulatory system, blood is not present in the blood vessels, hence it is known as the open blood vascular system. It is not closed blood vascular system. Open type of blood vascular system is present, and heart is absent, no heart is present, and no blood vessels. Blood vessels are also absent. That is why the system is not well developed in the echinodermata. And respiratory organs. Respiratory organs are well developed because they are found in the water or they are aquatic animals. They are papillae. In some animals, dermal branchia is also present in the skin region. Dermal branchiae, these are the helps in the respiration, but in some animals, cloacal respiratory organs are present. Cloacal respiratory organs are present. They are resembles to roots like that. They are situated at the cloacal region, hence they are known as the cloacal respiratory organs or trees are present. They are also useful for respiration, especially they are present in the sea cucumbers. Sea cucumbers, they are well developed here. And excretory organs, no excretory organs are present. Excretory organs are absent in this phylum. Excretion takes place by simple diffusion due to the absence of excretory organs. Simple diffusion. Nervous system. Nervous system as well as sensory organs are also not well developed. Nervous system and sense organs are poorly developed or absent. Are poorly developed or absent. No brain is also present. Brain is also absent. They are dioecious animals. Male and female animals are separate, and fertilization is external. External fertilization takes place. Both male and female animals are separate. They produce male gametes and female gametes. They are discharged into the water. In the water, male and female gametes are units and forms into zygote. Such processes takes place in the water. Hence, it is known as the external fertilization. They are dioecious animal. Externally, we cannot recognize the which is the male animal, which is the female animal. And development is takes place by larval forms, indirect development. Indirect development is takes place. There are different types of larval forms are present. Brachiolaria larva, amphipluteus larva, echinopluteus larva, bipinnaria larva. There are different types of larval forms are found in the life history of the echinoderms. That is why they are known as the indirect development, and the larva is free swimming and they shows the bilateral symmetry is present, advanced character is present in the larva, that is bilateral symmetry. They are free swimming animals. There are different types of larval forms are present here, and they show the regeneration power. Regeneration power is also very high. What is regeneration means? Regain the lost part of the body is known as the regeneration. This power is also very high in this animal. Some animals show the autotomy. What is autotomy means? If any enemy comes near to that and it is attached to the body, immediately that part is separated from the body, cut off the body, that is known as autotomy. And which part is lost from the body, it develops, that is known as the regeneration. Some animal shows the autotomy. This is also unique feature is present in the Echinodermata. The examples are Osterius, Echinus, these are the examples. There are so many examples are included in this phylum. Echinus and Osterius is the best examples for the phylum Echinodermata. Dolichocephalia larva is also present here. Ophiopluteus, Ophiura. Yes, these are the examples that comes under here. Yes, now we have to discuss the some more important characters of the phylum Echinodermata. Echinoderms means spiny skinned animals. They are exclusively marine animals. They are not found in fresh water. All are 100% of animals are found in the marine water only. And larva shows the bilateral symmetry. Adult shows the radial symmetry. They are deuterostomes and enterocoelomate animals. The presence of water vascular system, this is the unique feature of this phylum. This water vascular system is also known as umbilical system. It is useful for locomotion, respiration, excretion and food capturing. In spines are modified into papillae, they are useful for defense and also cleanness of the body. And respiratory organs are papillae, dermal branchiae in some animals, sea cucumbers, etc. They are present. They are known as the respiratory trees. They are situated at the cloacal region. And nervous system and sense organs are not well developed. They are unisexual animals. Fertilization is external, and different types of larval forms are present here. And they show the regeneration power. Some animals show the autotomy also. This is the some important features of the phylum Echinodermata.